funding during Dr. Cog's last call for projects that wrapped up last year in lieu of issuing a separate call. This funding is flexible in terms of end dates, and as such, Dr. Cog will work with the intended subrecipients to set grant periods that work it to meet all of the needs of the eight organizations. The agenda item does have a list of the intended subrecipients, the projects operating mobility management only, and the amount of the award. This was determined proportionally based on their current allocation of 5310 funding that's been awarded for operating mobility management projects. The motion before the committee today is to move to recommend to the board approval of the FTA Section 5310 CRISA and ARPA allocations based on the FTA 5310 call for projects conducted in April of 2020. I'm happy to address any questions that you all have.
Thank you so much for that presentation, Travis. That was fantastic. And I just want to thank the staff and all of the partner agencies for working so quickly on all of these different coronavirus relief programs. It's been a lot of extra effort, and it hasn't gone unnoticed how quickly you've been able to pull it all together. Director Williams.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I will be abstaining on this vote as I am a recipient of this funding.
Thank you, Director Williams. And I do think in all of our competitive projects, we have a project list and then many of our agencies receive the funding. So I do believe you are able to vote within our bylaws, but if you're more comfortable abstaining, that's completely fine too. Because I think that would make a lot of us ineligible on many of the different votes we take, like on the TIP and things like that. So it's your prerogative, but if you would like to vote, I do believe you can in our bylaws. Any other comments, questions, or would someone like to make a motion to frame the question? Looking for hands up. And with this quiet group, if you can't find your hand button, just go ahead and shout out if you'd like to make a motion. Don Stanton, Director Stanton.
Don Stanton, I so move the motion.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second, Shelley Cook.
Thank you, Shelley. Is there any further discussion of the motion? All right, so there's a motion on the floor for the board to approve the FTA Section 5310 CRISA and ARPA project allocations based on the FTA 5310 call for projects conducted in April 2020. Seeing no further discussion, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 Any opposed? Thank you. And any abstentions?
That's me.
Thank you. The motion carries. And that'll take us to our next agenda item this morning, which is action item 5, attachment C in your packet, the FY 2022 to 2025 Transportation Improvement Program TIP amendments. Todd Cottrell, our senior planner, is going to take us through that. And again, that's attachment C in your packet if you're following along that way. Todd, take it away.
Thank you, Madam Chair. So for this morning, we have three amendments for your consideration. But before I dive into that, just wanted to quickly remind RTC on the two different types of TIP adjustments that can be made for any TIP. The first being administrative modifications. And these are processed typically 10 to 12 times a year. These are processed internally by staff and then brought to the board of directors as an informational item. The second type of a TIP adjustment is simply called a TIP amendment. These are, of course, processed as needed. Like the ones that you're seeing before you this morning. But typically these are processed anywhere from 3 to 6 times a year. There are some differences between what is considered an administrative modification and a TIP amendment, but the major difference and typically what you see when these are brought forth is any change in a TIP project over $5 million. These amendments do need to go through the Dr. Cog committee process. So recommendations from TAC, RTC, and then final board approval. So going through that, I can quickly run through the three amendments that are before you this morning. The first is for the Region 1 Faster Pool. And this amendment would add 33 new pool projects, increase the cost on 2 existing pool projects, and then also remove 7. And these cover mainly activities in fiscal years 24 and 25. The overall total increase to the pool is $60 million. So both the second and the third amendment are connected, where $6.1 million is being added for phase 2 of the I-70 noise wall project. The amendments cover placing the funding into the I-70 noise wall project, which is actually the third amendment that is listed. And then in addition, we're also adding the pool project to the Region 1 RPP pool just for additional tracking purposes. And of course, that's the second amendment in your packet. So unless you have any comments or questions on these three amendments or the amendment process overall, the motion before you is to recommend to the Board of Directors the amendments to the 22 to 25 TIP.
Thank you very much, Mr. Cottrell. Any questions or comments? First is from Director Stewart.
Thank you. Chair, I'd like to move to approve the TIP amendments as proposed.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second, Wayne Shaw.
Thank you, Director Shaw. Is there any discussion of the motion or any other questions or comments on this agenda item today? Seeing none, we'll close the discussion and I'll ask all those in favor to please say aye.
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 Those opposed, please say no. Any abstentions? Thank you, everyone. The motion carries. And that takes us to our administrative items. Member comments and other matters is first up. Just want to remind everyone, it is Bike Month, even though we have canceled Bike to Work Day until September, not canceled, but postponed. It's still Bike Month. So for the rest of the month, if you haven't already been taking the opportunity, try to commit to switch some of those trips to biking or transit trips. If you can, RTD needs all our help getting their ridership back up. So if we can take transit trips, we can all make a difference. And with that, I'll turn it over to our Executive Director, Rex, to give our sincere thanks and goodbyes to one of our members. Director Rex.
Thank you, Madam Chair, very much. First of all, thanks everybody for tuning in today. I know it's a very short meeting, but the action items are important as part of our transportation planning process to get them through our Technical Advisory Committee, the RTC, and the board tomorrow night. So thank you all for your diligence. Yes, to the chair's point, I do want to recognize a member, which is my understanding is her last meeting, Commissioner Shannon Gifford. I'm sure I speak on behalf of all of our members, Shannon. I want to thank you so sincerely for your many years of public service. I know you served 8 years on the Transportation Commission. You're rolling off of that, and I know you're on the Denver Planning Board before that. A lot of time and effort went into the success of the Denver region on your behalf. So we thank you so very much for everything you do. Shannon, I think you've been on the RTC for as long as I've been at Dr. Cog. I don't know if that's right, but you're the only one I remember from District 1 anyway. So what I remember about Shannon is her thoughtfulness on transportation infrastructure investment. Just the importance that she's placed on on transportation planning and the necessity for that. So Shannon, thank you so very, very much. And we look forward to seeing you down the line in a different capacity.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you so much. What very well said, and the amount of commitment that you've shown the region over the years is truly amazing. And we can't thank you enough. Are there other member comments? All right, seeing none, the next meeting is not until July 20th. And so we'll see you then, and we are adjourned. Thank you, everyone.
Have a great day, everybody.
You too, thank you.
Bye, Shannon.